Yeah, I'm here to buy a notebook.
Oh, you came to the right place. We have notebooks up the butt. What kind of notebook are you looking for?
Give me a college rule.
Yeah, man. You really did. How's everybody doing tonight? If this is your first time seeing the Skit Parade, welcome back. If you've never seen the Skit Parade before, let's just tell you a touch about it. We wrote this show in 1 month and put it up just for you. This show will never be seen again except tomorrow night. So you're in for a treat. So sit back.
Yes, relax.
And enjoy the Skit Parade.
Yeah!
Knowing only that the blood would fuel me forever. A beast from hell, leaving a wake of death in my immortal path. Wow, you guys, look out there!
Wow!
Somebody had a breakthrough!
Mine too!
You guys can't be serious! This guy is obviously a-
Shut up, Larry!
No, guys, I think we can learn a little something from Brad here.
Connecting with our feelings is the quickest way to overcoming the addictions that rule our lives.
I think I'm gonna cry.
Me too.
Well, that's all the time we have for this week, guys. Keep checking in with your sponsors, and we'll see each other next week.
Oh, thank you all. Thank you all, really.
This is bullshit. I need to open up about my week-long drinking binge. I need help.
Would you like to come over for dinner, Larry? We can talk.
Bye, guys.
Nice to meet you, Brad. Nice to meet you, Brad.
Nice to meet you.
He's going to kill Larry, isn't he?
Totally.
People have been saying that the game of life seems dated, okay? So we gotta figure out ways to hook these millennials' kids. What do you got?
Marcus, first of all, I just gotta say, awesome job calling this meeting. You're an inspiration and a great leader.
Thanks, man.
Cool. No problem.
Yeah.
Let's talk spinner.
Okay.
Life's current spinner is way too small.
Yeah.
I was thinking double, triple the diameter. Okay. I want to feel a breeze when that motherfucker spins around.
I like it. A big eye section spinner. Excellent work, Jillian.
Big spinner. Excellent work, Jillian.
Yeah, maybe.
We could throw out the heteronormative formula that requires everyone to take a spouse.
Lydia, I love the woke phase you're going through right now. But we've already discussed the possible repercussions of pissing off the straight extremists.
We should worry more about that.
Lydia, repercussions.
Wait, inspiration is struck, guys. The spinner. It clicks, right?
Yeah.
We make each click loud.
Okay.
Loud, deafening clicks.
Okay.
Each one sounds like an oak tree just fucking snapping in
half. I love it. Excellent. And a loud ass spinner, and everyone in the block will know that we're playing a wonderful game of play. Perfect. Excellent work, Jill.
Excellent work. Wonderful game of life.
I have an idea.
What, Lydia?
We could have people skip the step that requires them to have a baby, since in real life there are other options.
Lydia, again, I'm going to have to ask you to hop off this woke train that you're on. First of all, we want people to have as many kids as possible, or else we're out of a job.
Yeah, but we still got to keep our babies.
Yeah, let's not talk about that right now. Second of all, I don't know if Corbett's gonna want to be cool with us citing Roe versus Wade and the instructions of a fucking kid's
game. The instructions of a kid's game, Lydia!
I am feeling extremely attacked right now.
Well, you can try coming up with some ideas that are actually fucking good. Like the spinner. We put lights on it.
Okay.
Multicolored lights. So it's like you're dancing at a fucking nightclub while you're playing the game of life.
I like it. Yes, now we are on to something.
Yeah, I agree.
You can sit down. I mean,
yeah.
Go ahead and sit down. You're
good.
Yeah.
Okay. Hear me out.
Okay.
We could have people, we could add a skit step that makes people lose their life savings because they got hit by a hurricane, because we haven't addressed climate change.
Lydia, can you have one fucking idea in your entire career without bringing up something political? And one fucking idea in your entire life, Lydia.
Whole life.
You got this.
Okay, fine. We could add a second fucking spinner.
Oh, fuck you! That's a great idea. Let's keep it up, okay.
Guys, this has been a great brainstorm.
Yeah, it really has.
Wonderful meeting. One more thing. We could have women make 70 cents on the dollar every...
God damn it, Lydia! I'm gonna transfer your ass to Candyland!
Hell! Lydia! Candyland! Leave us!
before I forget, it's Debbie's birthday, so everybody remember to sign the card.
Thank you. Hamilton?
But he's a girl Hamilton?
Oh my god, Lin-Manuel is a guy! even if he wasn't, would it matter? Because diversity?
Trick-or-treat.
Well then, trick it is.
Here you go, boys. Have a great Halloween.
Thank you.
You didn't let me finish my trick.
I am starting to reevaluate our relationship.
Trick-or-treat!
Oh, why are you looking at the scary mummy?
No, not a mummy.
Of course you are. You're wrapped head to foot in mummy wrappings.
No. I'm someone with mild burns because that's our future if we don't get climate change under control.
You really didn't get that, huh?
It's not important. I believe I heard someone say trick or treat.
I did.
Well, then a trick you shall have.
No. Here you go.
Oh, thank you.
Have a good night.
Okay.
Do you even care about climate change?
A, that's a hoax. And B, what's with all the weird costumes?
They're not weird. They're creative and intelligent. Also, what?
Trick-or-treat!
Oh. Hello.
Okay, what are they?
Well, I can clearly see that they're a prom king and queen.
Okay, what else?
A popular prom king and queen?
Are you serious? No. Love the costumes. Very creative way to draw awareness to two of the eating disorders that plague society.
What are you talking about?
Let's see. Anorexic and bulimic.
Right!
How?
Are you honestly that ignorant? Men can have eating disorders too.
What? You know what? Forget it. Here's a trick.
Nope, you lost your trick privileges.
Thank you.
What the hell is happening to Halloween?
Oh my god! Good job, guys!
What? They're not even wearing any costumes!
I know, it's great!
What, think they're too old or too cool to dress up for Halloween?
You're an asshole.
We're trick-or-treating for a UNICEF!
For the people of Puerto Rico who lost lots of things in Hurricane Maria.
And it's all their costumes!
Oh, come on!
And including all the candy that we'll collect tonight.
We will be sending to the struggling children of Puerto Rico.
Oh my god,
you
guys
should. Good
god.
Thank you.
What is wrong with you?
Me? What's wrong with those stupid kids? Those last ones didn't even deserve a trick. Oh, honey, look, it's a football player.
Trick or treat.
Yeah, we'll get to that, but let me just go ahead and guess this right off the bat. So you're not just a football player, right? Let me see. You're a football player that kneels for the national anthem, or you've got that whatever that head concussion thing is, or maybe you're here protesting some other socioeconomical, geopolitical issue, right? Right?
Nah, I'm just Golden Tate the Third.
Here's all the candy we got. Oh, and my rings and my cards.
Thank you.
Well, you finally did a trick to make something disappear.
What's that?
Me.
Yes, what's this? This color everywhere. What's this? This black and silver hair. What's this? I can't believe my eyes. I must be dreaming of the jack. This is a fair. What's this? What's this? What's this? There's something very wrong. What's this? There's people singing songs. What's this? The streets are lined with little creatures laughing. Everybody seems so happy. Have I found something I'm laughing with? What's this?
Oh, hey there, everyone. I'm Alfred, and I'm a panda. I just want to thank everybody for giving me a home at the San Diego Zoo. If it weren't for people like you and the folks at the World Wildlife Federation, I probably wouldn't be here today. That being said, please, let me die. No. I read on Yahoo News that I'm no longer an endangered species, but I'm now on the vulnerable list. Well, I know. I've known I've been vulnerable ever since I was a tiny panda fetus. Listen, I know I'm cute. Thanks for noticing. But I'm miserable. And I'll tell you why. First of all, my main source of nutrition doesn't provide any nutrition at all. I have to eat 27 pounds of bamboo every day just to stay alive. In fact, I eat so much that I actually poop while I'm eating. Take a moment to picture that, ladies and gentlemen. I poop while I'm eating. It's like I'm a human centipede, except it's just my own mouth, my own stomach, and my own butthole. And that's not a good thought. You know what else is a really bad thought? Panda parenting. We're such bad parents. In fact, just this morning, I ate my only son because I thought he was a breakfast burrito. You know, he was a good kid, but he was a fucking amazing breakfast burrito. I gotta be careful with that though, because it's really hard to make panda babies. Panda chicks are never down to bed. In fact, did you know pandas only ovulate one fucking time a year? You try guessing which pond panda is ovulating at any given moment. It's impossible. Little known fact, human women only ovulate once every 4 weeks. Write that down. And they have to keep an app to keep track of them. If and when sex ever does happen, my body is so mumpy and awkward that I have to move my enormous stomach for any chance for this panda lady to see my panda dog having anywhere near her delicate flow. Bad chance of that happening. Needless to say, thank you for giving me all of these millions of dollars, but I gotta say, it was for nothing. I have a better idea. Save the bees. I know they're assholes, believe me, but they're better for our ecosystem. I saw it on Netflix. So please, while I appreciate the effort, what are you keeping me alive for? Because I'm cute? That's flattering, but I don't want to ruin everyone's good time, including my own. So please, from the bottom of my heart, let me die.
This message brought to you by the bees.
Look at the food. To put the food next to the body so you can breathe and
embroidered onto these napkins. Where the fuck is the G in the name of those? Hey, where the fuck is the G?
There isn't one. Damn straight, there's not something. This backstabbing to just stole my G, my dress, my book, my food, my flowers, my...
So literally just pictures of me. She literally stole my hat!
I just don't know why she would do this.
There's a reason I planned all of this out. Remember Dorothy Service, aka the Crap Fest of 2016?
Oh, poor Dorothy, that stroke took her so fast!
So fast they couldn't pick out a better dress! And her makeup, she looked like an Amish clown! I swore I wouldn't let my funeral the hands of my idiot children. So I sat down that day and I planned everything out, from my clothing to my favorite Aaron Neville song.
I don't know much, but I know I love you.
Liz, please, I'm gonna have to ask you to control yourself.
We're very sorry. We just lost our dear friend of over 30 years, and it's just so hard. We're very sorry.
Martha wrote a letter that she asked me to read at the service, but maybe it'll serve us better now. Dear loved ones, I wish we could be meeting in better circumstances. I'd like to thank everyone for coming today. I'd like to thank my two best friends, who are really more like sisters, Gertrude and Liza, for helping me navigate this world, and to whom I owe everything for making me the woman I became. I love you both very much, and I dedicate this service to our friendship. May our love for each other cross into the afterlife.
That actually was very nice. See, she loved you very much. Perhaps I overreacted. I think you did.
I'm glad you guys have found some peace. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to go turn on the generator for the Rainbow Tunnel.
Rainbow Tunnel?
Liza, weren't you going to have that at your funeral? Making your sim love the Jesse sim!
Sims anymore, baby.
All my friends thought I was crazy, but I knew we'd be together.
Yes!
I knew it like I know your favorite color is Tar Heel blue, or your favorite word is crunk.
Those are still true things!
I want to raise my Tamagotchi with you!
Come, let's be together. You, me, and the baby. I know it didn't happen in a bathtub during a tornado like your many fanfictions, but I hope you can look past that.
Oh, Justin Timberlake, I surely can. Who is it?
Hi, it's me, Mr. Hughes, your high school principal. I got your letter.
Looks insane!
Oh my god, I am so scared. Well, I love it!
Welcome, riders, let's get you strapped in. You guys ready? You all set?
Yup!
All set! She's cheating on you.
What?
What?
I don't know what he's talking about.
Who are you sleeping with?
Nobody!
You know what? That's it, I'm getting off this fucking thing.
Sir, the ride is about to start.
Is it Jason?
No.
Is it Freddy?
No.
Is it Peterson?
Ew.
Think about this logically. We live over 900 miles away. How would this guy know anything about our personal lives?
Oh my god. You're right. I don't know what came over me. I'm so sorry.
It's okay. He's just some sort of jerk, obviously.
I love you so much.
I love you too.
And welcome back, riders. How was that ride?
What are you talking about? We didn't go anywhere.
It's more of an emotional roller coaster.
You monster.
Sure, I'm literally gonna go fuck some animals!
like no getting it on with animals.
He's gonna go and fuck some animals.
We hope you all enjoyed our last segment on 7 easy ways to clean your house with things that you already have in your home.
I did. Now I have an excuse for hoarding my garbage.
Oh, right, Sherry. Now, over the break, we were talking about this hot new show, Game of Thrones. Gosh, Sherry, I just think it's the greatest show. Have you watched it from the beginning?
No, I just binge-watched the entire series last week.
So you have watched it from the beginning?
No, I binged them, Travis.
All 7 seasons?
Yeah, I watched each episode back to back until I thought I was a White Walker.
Oh my goodness, that is dedication. Sherry, now did you know, little known fact, the dragons on that show aren't real dragons at all.
They aren't?
No, in fact, they are made by computers. Breaking news. Richie, I heard we have breaking news.
Yes, Travis, I'm here outside Greektown Casino where there seems to be something going on in the sky. Seems some sort of crafts are hovering over Detroit.
Wow, Richie, that's really interesting. You think they might be dragons?
What?
Richie, do you watch Game of Thrones?
No, I'm more of a documentary kind of guy. But did you guys not hear me? There are UFOs hovering over Detroit.
All right.
Wow, he's never seen it.
Richie. All right, Richie. Don't have too much fun out there. Hey, put 20 on red for me. Okay, Richie.
Wow, ladies. Yeah. And ladies, Richie is single.
Now, Sherry, I know you love to cook, and I heard that you just put a brand new twist on an old favorite.
Oh, yes, Travis. Great segue for our next segment. You know, everyone loves a good mimosa.
Sure.
But later in the day, sometimes the champagne just isn't enough. So listen to this. I started putting vodka in my orange juice instead of the champagne.
Wow, Sherry, you are a raging alcoholic.
Over the right is the game room with the pool table, and before you ask, yes, it does come with the house. Over this way is one of the three full bathrooms, and up the spiral staircase there is the master bedroom with a master bath and two walk-in closets.
This place is fantastic, but it can't possibly be in our budget.
Yeah, we were looking for more of a fixer-upper. This place looks like Matt Damon would live here.
I'm sure you guys it's not. This is well within your budget. I'm actually been having a hard time selling this place for a couple of years now.
How? Who wouldn't want this place?
Seriously, there's like not a single thing wrong with it.
Yeah, what? Are like toilets broken or something?
No. it's hard to say, guys, but I just can't sell this place because...
Oh, God. Was this place a whorehouse or something?
Honey, there are worse things.
You would say that.
We've talked about this. That part of my life is behind me.
Oh, is it?
It wasn't a whorehouse or anything, guys. The reason I haven't been able to sell it for a couple years is because of that demon child in the corner.
Oh, Jesus Christ! How long has that been there?
The best expert I could find said he's been here for, three life cycles, whatever that means.
Where are his parents?
Oh, man, his parents died centuries ago. Yeah, they fell down a well and died instantly. He waited by the well for weeks for them to come out of it and died of starvation. Some say that the mother still haunts the earth looking for blah, 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 but you guys have heard this all before, I'm sure.
Come on, you guys. He's just a little boy in need of some love.
You know, every house comes with a project.
That's not the kind of project we're looking for!
I guess we won't be able to live here.
You know, most people say that, but this house is actually well below your budget.
We don't care!
How much lower are we talking about?
They're only asking for $75K.
$75K? Can we have a moment?
Of course, I'm gonna go put on some cream.
You're serious, right?
Just think how cool we would be. We'd have a fun, spooky house. We'd have these badass Halloween parties that everybody would want to come to.
Live in a house with a demon child after all we've been through?
Yeah. So, I mean, 75K is a total steal.
You're being for real right now.
Of course.
Oh! Ah! Ah! Don't run to me! You're the one that wanted to buy a haunted house!
Can't we just consider it? I mean... we've always wanted a house like this, though. I mean, a house that we could call our own, a house we could have a family in and grow into. Who cares that there's a small demon boy mourning over his dead parents? I think we can make this work. We just throw down a rug, I don't know, maybe put up some Venetian blinds, add a diffuser of some sort to the bathroom, and maybe some new lighting fixtures.
I'm never gonna sell this house.
At least they didn't notice the cracks in the foundation.
Amateurs!
Thank you.
one more time, that is tomorrow night at 8 o'clock. Tell a friend, and if you didn't enjoy it, tell an enemy. Send them our way. We'd love to see them. At 9:30 in this very theater is a recording of a podcast called Transmissions from the Dark Side. We are going to watch an episode of seminal 80s horror anthology series, Tales from the Dark Side, which isn't funny in any way, shape, or form. And then we're going to rag on it and make it hysterical. We'd love for you to stick around for that, but if you have to go, have a great night. Let's give it up for the cast one more time!